precious name, Jesus Christ. Quit hanging with the wrong people. Amen, somebody. We always go to church. We want the blessing from God, but today we're going to get the beating from God. Amen, somebody. Because the blessings only can help you smile, but the beating will help you live. Amen, somebody. And the first whooping thing is quit hanging with the wrong people. There's too many people in our lives that are only concerned with themselves. And that's the first step, that you hanging with the wrong ones. Amen, somebody. Every time you talk, all they want to talk about is I, which means they really don't care about you. When every time you talk to them, all they want to talk about what they got going on and what they like, what they had for lunch, what they want to do, what they like. But they ain't never got time to talk about what you want to do, how you feeling, what you going through. And when you got people that only want to talk about I, that's the first sign that they really don't care about you. Many of us are stuck because people around us won't help us get free. Jesus Christ. If you don't have nobody you can trust with your problems, you will find yourself stuck with those problems. I'm going to say that again. Amen, somebody. If you don't have nobody in your life that you can trust with your problems, then you will find yourself stuck with those problems. And so many of y'all been watching Tired Prayer. I ain't talking about the falling of grace. Amen. I'm talking about I can do bad all by myself. And because you got in your mind that you can do bad all by yourself, every time you look around, you still dealing with the same mess all by yourself. The text is telling the teachers today that you can't do this thing by yourself. Can't do this by yourself. You need people in your life that can take, that you can take your problems to, and they won't take it to nobody but God. Jesus Christ, man. You need people in your life that when I tell you about what I'm going through, I don't worry about seeing it on Facebook the next day. Amen, somebody. You need people in your life that you can vent to, and they don't take it to nobody but God. Because they take it to anybody else, all they doing is making your problem bigger than what it really is. But if they take your problem to God, then God's going to handle your problem.
Amen.
May I suggest some of us still got the same problems because we talking to people and ain't this the time to talk to God? You know you're hanging with the wrong people when you keep repeating your problem and they don't say nothing back that touches you. How can you have the same best friend and talk about the same Negro every day and you still laying with that Negro? If my best friend calls me every day and tell me bad news about their relationship, eventually the God inside of me is going to tell them to leave the relationship. But you let your best friend fuss and cuss every day about the same no good Negro, when you going to get the cuss? It's better than what you just need.
Amen.
You know you're hanging with the wrong people when you keep repeating your problem and they don't say nothing back that touches you. Amen, somebody. You need people in your life that know that I'm not doing this for me, but I'm doing this for us. Amen. I'm going to say that again. I'm not doing this for me, but I'm going to do this for us. Because it's not for me, but it's for us. Because when I get my life together, we going to be better. Amen, somebody. Mm-mm-mm. It's easy to pray that somebody gets blessed, but when the last time you pray for somebody that whatever's breaking them will leave them alone.
Amen.
It's easy to pray somebody gets blessed, but when the last time that you gonna pray for what's breaking them? We always want to speak five blessings over your life. I speak a new car over your life. I speak a new house over your life. No, baby, I don't need no car. I'm fine with the one I got. I don't need no mansion. I'm fine with the one I got. I need a peace of mind from this devil that I'm dealing with. Stop always going to God about material things and start going to God about spiritual things. The text, Jesus is talking about people with problems, dealing with self and sin. And we always heard this, when two or three, you know, ask in his name, he shall be given. Amen, somebody. And I've seen preachers my whole life abuse this text, amen, because they said, grab your neighbor by the hand. And when you get your neighbor by the hand, just grab him and shake him and tell neighbor that that Mercedes is going to be yours. And they just use this text all the time to talk about getting material things. Amen, somebody. But if you go home tonight and you read the Bible for yourself, in verse chapter 18, Jesus is talking about people with some problems. He says, the people got some problems. How do you handle people in the church with problems?
Come on.
He said, first you got to bring them to the elder. No, I'm sorry. He said, first you take them to the side.
Yeah.
and you tell them to the side, well, listen, this is what you're dealing with, and you need to get better. And then if they don't listen, then you take them to the elder of the church. And tell the elder of the church, well, listen, this is what they're dealing with, and if they don't do that, then you take them in front of the church. But he's talking about how you deal with problems inside of the church. Amen, somebody. How do you deal with people that got some real life problems, people that's dealing with some things that they just can't shake. Amen, somebody. And so we cannot come to church every time and look for the preacher to speak blessings over our life when you go home to get beat. Tell me, in the text, Jesus is talking about people with problems dealing with self and sin. And we only want to touch the grief of the blessing, but we never want to touch the grief of the deliverance of the burdens. I'm going to say that again. Amen. We only want to touch the grief of the blessings, but we never want to touch the grief of the deliverance of the burden. I dare you to turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, I don't know what you're dealing with, but I pray that God delivers you of that demon. Oh my God, there you go. Start speaking blessings over your labor life, because that's the biggest blessing that you can get, because they can get rid of the demon, then they can get what they want on their own. Amen, somebody. It's not that they don't have the tools, it's not that they don't have the mind brain, it's not that they don't have the talent. They just dealing with a demon that won't let them go. Don't you worry about trying to bless me with a new car. No, help me with this demon, I'm going to get my own car. Help me with this sickness, and I'll get up and get my own job. I don't need no handout. I'm not begging for a handout. I need a hand in getting this demon off my life.
I hope that you enjoyed this service. You can get on Facebook Live right now.